Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. For those of you new here, hello, my name is Skylar. I am a certified dog trainer and pet nutritionist. Today we are going to be doing our first installment of Ask a Dog Trainer, where I take viewer submitted questions about dog behavior and dog training and lend my professional experience as a trainer to you guys to answer any training and behavior questions that you may be having. Let's jump right on into our first question. Hi, I'm working on training my Bernese Mountain Dog puppy to walk on a leash. I'm really interested in using force-free and positive reinforcement-based methods, so we're walking on a front clip harness. Perfect. I have a nosy neighbor who keeps trying to give me advice, and while I'm sure her intentions are good, I'm afraid that these are going to harm my dog over time. Just recently, she took the leash from me, wrapped around his belly in a burrito hold, and tried to get me to walk him that way as opposed to on the front clip harness. How do I deal with this? What do I do? So this is a great question, and I feel like something a lot of people could probably relate to. Just friends, family, nosy neighbors trying to encroach on your personal training methods and give you some advice. Now, of course, this is probably from a place of trying to help, especially with a big Bernese Mountain Dog puppy. These guys, they get big and they were bred to pull. Working on your leash manners and really paying attention to pulling early on is going to help to nip that bad habit in the bud and create a really good foundation for great leash manners as they get bigger and older. I also have to commend you for using a front clip harness and for showing an interest in positive reinforcement and force-free methods. Especially for puppies, but even any age, any breed, any size, these methods are the best for everyone. It creates a really comfortable environment to learn in. You aren't using coercion or stress to get the behaviors that you're looking for, and instead you're focusing on rewarding the positive, which is awesome. The method that is described that the neighbor is using is something that some people, some trainers, use, where they take the leash that's usually attached to a collar, they'll wrap it around the waist of the dog and essentially turn it into a choke chain for the belly. I am not a fan of these methods for the same reason why I am not a fan of choke chains. This whole method relies on the extreme discomfort of the shortening belt, I guess is a good way to put it, to make the dog unwilling to continue to pull. Understandably, this is not a method that I advocate for, and this is actually a method that I encourage you not to continue, although it sounds like you're not in that boat anyway. What I would recommend you do is next time your neighbor tries to approach you, offer advice, thank you for the advice. I'm currently working with a trainer who has me using these methods. I'm going to be following the training plan that has been set out for me. Whether you're working with a trainer or not, now you are, you don't have to lie. Being able to be firm with your boundaries, whether it be, again, family, friends, neighbors, is gonna be very, very important, especially while you're training. A lot of times people are gonna come up trying to pet your dog or trying to offer their advice, and just that simple line of thank you, but I'm working with a professional who's decided that this is gonna be the best method for me and this is what I'm choosing to do, is a phrase that I want you to be very comfortable with, because it's true, you've done all this research and you're seeking professional advice and this is what's being given to you. I also am very bothered by the fact that it seems like your neighbor was very cool with just taking the leash from you and doing this to your dog, which sounds like you are very uncomfortable with. You are also your dog's advocate, so being sure to express your discomfort or express discomfort on behalf of your dog is gonna be a very important thing to start getting used to as well. Hopefully this particular situation does not happen again, and I hope that you're able to then talk to your neighbor. Again, simple thank you, then move on. I have a 2-year-old corgi and I've been trying to get her in a harness as opposed to her collar. Perfect. But since her body is so long and disproportionate to her legs, most harnesses either don't fit her or she's able to wiggle out of them pretty easily. Do you have any advice or recommendations for good harnesses for dogs with longer bodies? Basset hounds, corgis, wiener dogs, all of these dogs with the very long bodies and the very short legs are very disproportionate, and quite frankly, it's hard to find things to fit them. My best recommendation is to find a harness that has a bit of a longer back. This is not only going to aesthetically look like it fits them a lot better, but chances are it will fit them a lot better. A great example of this, and the one that I probably recommend the most, is the RUFFWEAR FLAGLINE harness. This one here is a lot longer. It also has a whole nother set of buckles. So you have the buckles that go right behind the front legs, and you also have another set of buckles that goes right about at the waist. So this is giving you a bit more of a customized fit as well, so less likely to wiggle out and have loose gaps. The RUFFWEAR harnesses are also really well made, and they do have a little tab in the front, so you do have a front clip option if you'd like to use that as well. Again, the biggest thing about these that I like, besides just the fact that it's long, is it has multiple points of adjustment. So you have an adjustable neck and shoulder, you have an adjustable right behind the front legs, and you're able to make adjustments right at the waist or further down. So you're able to get a perfectly fitted harness that's more comfortable for the dog, less chafing, less moving around. It's also going to be harder to wiggle out of because it's so perfectly fit. And these harnesses are just really durable and really nice. They are a little bit more expensive than some of the other harnesses on the market, but it's definitely worth the price. I have RUFFWEAR harnesses for my dogs, and I love them. Last but not least, I just got a new puppy and he will not stop biting me. I don't know what to do and his teeth are so sharp. Please help. Now, the biggest thing with puppies is understanding that they explore their world a large part with their mouths. They're very much like human babies in that way, where everything goes in the mouth, we figure out if it's food or not, and we move on. My best recommendation, whether your puppy's chewing on you or your furniture, is for every one thing that they cannot chew on, you want at least two things that they can chew on within arm's reach. This gives you the perfect opportunity to redirect them, and instead of just having a strong no, and then they don't know what else they can chew on, you have an option that they can be chewing on instead. So redirecting them away from the furniture, redirecting them away from your ankles, and giving them something positive that they can be chewing on instead. It's gonna be perfect. With hands especially, if you need to, approach your dog with something in your hand ready to shove in their mouth so that they can't even get to you. One of the biggest things that I notice people do with puppies especially, that can actually lead to your hands getting nibbled and continue that habit throughout the rest of their life, is using your hands as toys. You should never be using your hands as toys. Your hands are not toys, your hands are hands. Oftentimes I'll notice pet owners kind of doing this with their dog's face and wiggling their fingers and having their puppy go after their fingers. While this seems fun at the time, you can see how fingers being toys is not a good thing to teach a dog long term. That puppy is gonna get a lot bigger, presumably. And those bites are gonna hurt a lot more and potentially get you in a lawsuit, depending on whose fingers end up in the mess. Because of that, you should never use your hands as toys. You can absolutely use toys to play with your dog. Extremely encouraged. Have toys in your hand, toss them for them, throw a rope, whatever you wanna do. Play with your dog, please. Play with your puppy, have so much fun. Just don't use your hands as toys. Now, if you're at a total loss, your puppy's chewing on everything, there are sprays that you can use that leave a bitter taste in the dog's mouth that can discourage them from chewing on different surfaces. For example, there's bitter yuck, bitter apple, bitter cherry. More than welcome to try those. However, it's not a Band-Aid. The biggest problem that I run into is people will say, hey, I bought this spray, my puppy is still chewing. The deterrent itself might not be enough of a deterrent to stop them if they're not given something else that they could be chewing better. For example, if your puppy is chewing a chair leg, you can spray it down with a bitter yuck or a bitter apple, but then also make sure that you're redirecting them to something positive that they can be chewing on. Now, my absolute best recommendation for a good thing that your puppy can be chewing on, frozen Kongs. Hands down, one of my favorite tools. And it doesn't have to be a Kong. The Westpaw Topple is another one of my absolute favorites. It's more of a bowl shape, so it can be a little bit less frustrating for some dogs to get out. These guys I fill with canned dog food. You can also fill it with peanut butter or unsweetened applesauce or yogurt, but for the most part, I'd probably stick with a canned dog food, especially for now, because puppies' tummies are a little bit of a mess. Stuff it, and then I put it in the freezer and freeze it solid. This makes it last a whole lot longer, makes much less of a mess on my floors. It also helps to numb the gums during teething because you have that nice cold something something to help numb the gums and make things a little bit more comfortable. These are great puppy babysitters as well. So if you just need to like make dinner or take a shower and you can't be on puppy patrol 24/7, these are nice to just pop in a crate with them. I wouldn't leave them completely unsupervised just for safety, but in a crate, you can go take a shower. Another big thing that can lead to your puppy being super mouthy and super nippy is gonna be if they're overtired or if they're frustrated. Just like human babies, puppies get overtired, they need naps. So after you start to notice that maybe your puppy gets super wound up, and not necessarily in an energy way, just like a little demon way, it's probably time to go take a nap. So you can put them back in their kennel in a secluded room in the house. It gives you another chance to get some stuff done while they not only get to take a little bit of a break, but you're also teaching them a little bit about independence and that they don't always need to be attached to you like Velcro. This is going to be very important for their development as they grow anyway, because you want your dog to be comfortable being away from you and having their own space. They don't need to be right up against you all the time. I hope those answered some of the questions that you might have about your own dogs or your own training journey. If you have any other questions for me that you would like me to answer in a future video, please be sure to leave those down in the comment section below. You can also follow me on Instagram at tattooed.dogtrainer or topdogbehavior for more of my businessy stuff. But at the tattooed.dogtrainer profile, that's where I do a lot of the ask me anything about training kind of Instagram story questions, where I get a lot of these questions that I share on my videos. So that's another great place to wait for me to put out, and then you can submit your questions as well. If you liked this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Again, I think this channel is a great resource for a lot of pet owners, and I would love to have you part of our community. So, until next time, bye!